snowy day there in Washington.
Yeah, nice music to go with it,
yeah.
Too. Jolly. Okay, welcome back to the programme. Now, many families around the world are no longer celebrating just one holiday this time of year. As cultures mix and ethnic backgrounds blend, some apparently are suffering from cultural confusion.
You know all about that. Well, a bright young author has picked up on that theme and has written a book based on her own clash of cultures. Tanujay Desai-Idie is the author of Born Confused, and she spoke with us earlier about her motivation.
The title of the book, Born Confused, actually comes from the term American-born confused Desi, and that is a term. Desi means from my country, like a homegirl or a homeboy. And that term is a term that first-generation South Asians often use to describe these second-generation South Asian Americans who are supposedly, you know, confused about where they come from and where they belong. There are a few different reasons that sort of compelled me to write this book, and one was to make sense of a period of complete cultural confusion and exhilaration, you know, that I personally was experiencing as an Indian American person living in New York City. Sort of the mid to late 90s suddenly saw this huge explosion of South Asian youth culture as sort of second generation South Asian America, you know, kind of came of age, and you had Bhangra party nights with lines wrapped around the block and Asian underground concerts and, you know, South Asian studies departments being introduced in academic environments and all sorts of, you know, heated debates and discussions on culture and to whom it belongs. And the interesting thing, I mean, you sort of on the one hand had a lot of second generation South Asian Americans who were for the first time perhaps ever in some cases starting to really embrace the South Asian part of their heritage, you know, starting to wear the bindi as a symbol of kind of a newfound connection they were feeling to the culture. And at the same time, an interesting thing that was happening was you had this sort of, you know, huge preoccupation with all things Indian. You can wear a traditional sari and be a radical feminist thinker, and you can dress in a, you know, skimpy crop top and wear body glitter and actually have kind of traditional hopes for the kind of lifestyle you would lead. And you don't have to, it's all about context and it's all about intention, and you don't have to sort of define things in such a rigid way that that you end up feeling like you don't fit. There's another way to see the neither here nor there as being really a you are here.
And we'll be bringing you more conversations with authors in the future, and we'd like to know what you're reading. Be sure to visit our website at cnn.com/yourworldtoday or YWT. Send us an email. The address is YWT@cnn.com. Your recommendations and suggestions could be used in the future for future book segments. And we're going to take a quick break now.